When I was a child, my mother insisted I wash my hands, particularly after I'd been playing outside in the dirt, because it was, well, dirty and surely full of germs. I can still hear her voice telling me to wash up. Face it, we are a society of germaphobes who have been brought up to believe that all bugs are bad bugs. But the fact is, most bugs, or shall we say microbes, that include bacteria and fungi, are actually good. And what's more, microbes produce compounds which they use to defend themselves against their fellow microbes. These are naturally produced antibiotics. In fact, the first antibiotics were extracted from soil microbes. These became the wonder drugs of the mid-20th century, all but eliminating diseases like tuberculosis. But here's the twist. In the 20th century, scientists could only screen microbes that could be cultured in a lab. And that's only about 1% of all soil microbes. This limitation has meant that the emergence of antibiotic-resistant superbugs, like MRSA, and new strains of tuberculosis, was inevitable. We were left with this vast, untapped resource of uncooperative microbes that refuse to grow in a petri dish. But recently, Northeastern University's Kem Lewis, in collaboration with Slava Epstein and a biotech company, Novobiotic, used an ingenious device called the iChip to trick isolates of uncooperative microbes into growing as if they were still in the soil. They've been able to discover 50,000 new isolates and 25 new antibiotics. One microbe, Eleftheria terrae, produces an antibiotic called Texobactin, which shows great promise in overcoming antibiotic resistance. Now, I'm not ready to toss the hand sanitizer or stop washing my hands. But knowing that our living soil stores the possibility of life-saving antibiotics, how cool is that?